It's your boy Indian Guru in the house, back with another bang on video. Well, this video is again special because Arsenal are going to face Burnley tomorrow and we are going to have a cracker jack of a game. The only reason why I'm saying this is that I'm expecting really good competition from Burnley, and they have won 3-0 game in their opening game, opening match in the match day one. And this is really great to see how Burnley have resurrected themselves under Sean Dyche. But make no mistake, I think last season we won both the games and Sean Dyche was complaining that we cheated or everything was against us. But this time, it won't be said by Sean Dyche because I think there is VAR. And I think even if there is a complaint or something, VAR has its own problems. Yeah, I think we saw the final penalty at the Liverpool versus Chelsea in the UEFA Super Cup. Adrian was off the line and still, but according to the VAR officials, it was definitely not a VAR code breach. So whatever may be the rules, whatever may be the situation, I really don't want to comment more on that. But make no mistake, I am expecting this game to be really good because I know how physical Burnley are. Yeah, but before moving on to the video, I think we'll analyze everything, how Arsenal can improve and how Arsenal can go forward and destroy Burnley. But I'd always, as I mentioned, please subscribe to this channel, hit that bell icon so you get notifications whenever I post a video on YouTube. And make no mistake, I post daily Arsenal stuff. Yeah, if you ask me what is there for you in this channel, if you're an Arsenal fan, it is a really good way for you to know more and more about Arsenal, whatever Arsenal is doing, all the news you get in this channel. And every news, you can follow every player as well. And also about the match day, before the matches, we do the preview and after the game, we do the analysis and we rate the performance, how exactly every Arsenal player have performed and what can we expect them in the coming future in this campaign of theirs. So let's see what's going to happen. Yeah. Watch the video till the end so you get everything, every knowledge about Arsenal versus Burnley. How big is this competition? How Arsenal have fared against Burnley? Well, let's go on with the video. Well, Arsenal versus Burnley is always a one-sided contest. Arsenal dominating Burnley, that's always, I think, even during the Wenger era, that never changed. So I think I want to say one thing, that in this game competition, this is the first home game for Arsenal in this season. Yeah. Last year, we saw the first home game, Arsenal lost 2-0 to Manchester City. But this is Burnley, okay? And we are starting a new season. And last season, we won 14 games out of this, out of the whole competitions at home. And we were dominating at home, okay? So the only thing that I can say and I can remind everyone, all the fans, is that we have to be excited because this has to be a high-scoring contest for Arsenal. Yeah, I'm expecting that. But let's talk about the match first. Yeah, Arsenal versus Burnley. What is it all about? Well, the venue is the Emirates Stadium. Well, it kicks off at 12:30 BST, and the match officials are the referee Mike Dean. Yes, Mike Dean is the referee for this game, and I'm really I know how exactly Mike Dean performs, but I'm expecting this to be, since it's going to be more of a physical game, Mike Dean is definitely a no bullshit referee. Definitely, that's going to be there. The assistant referees are Darren Cann and Dan Robathan. The fourth official, Peter Banks. And video assistant referee, Chris Kavanagh. And video assistant is Andy Halliday. Well, these were all the official news and everything that you wanted to know. And most importantly, the team news. Let's talk about the Arsenal team news first. Arsenal team news, we all know Hector Bellerin, Dinos Mavropanos, Kieran Tierney and Rob Holding will be unavailable for the match. And most importantly, Granit Xhaka will be assessed ahead of the game because he's affected with lower leg bruising, which he sustained. And let's talk about the Burnley team news. Burnley team news, Danny Drinkwater is unlikely to feature while building fitness. Robbie Brady will miss the tie with rib issues. Well, these are the things that are going to happen. Well, obviously, I think I think so. Even if Granit Xhaka is not playing, I don't think so we're going to miss him. Because I'd like to see Torreira. Oh, Torreira. I'd like to see Lucas Torreira start for Arsenal. Definitely at a home game. He's buzzing as always. I'd want Torreira and Guendouzi to start. But it's a competition where you're going to see a captain named, and I'd like to also like to see Granit Xhaka firing all cylinders. I want to see a Xhaka boom, yeah. I don't want to see the sloppy Xhaka which started at Newcastle. Definitely not. Well, let's talk about the potential starting 11, and later on I'll tell you what I expect from Arsenal as a starting 11. For Arsenal, I think the potential are Leno, Ainsley Maitland-Niles, Socrates, David Luiz, Nacho Monreal, Granit Xhaka, Matteo Guendouzi, Dani Ceballos, Nicolas Pepe, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, and Alexandre Lacazette. And most importantly for Burnley, Pope, Loughton, Tarkowski, Mee, Peters, Goodmanson, Cork, Westwood, McNeil, Wood, and Barnes. Well, we all know how Burnley could get under our nerves, and how they can affect us in every way, shape, or form. And most importantly, this was the potential 11. This was all the details that you'd like to see about Arsenal. Let's now talk about the insights of the game. Well, Arsenal have won their last 10 matches against Burnley in all competitions since March 2010. Since March 2010, Arsenal have never lost to Burnley. They've drawn or either won all the games, but they've never lost to Burnley. The last that Burnley won against Arsenal, that was I think in 1974 September at Highbury, and they won 1-0. That is the last memory of Burnley beating Arsenal. So Arsenal have been dominating against Burnley, and this is definitely going to be seen in this game as well. The encounter will be really great. And most importantly, in the Premier League, Arsenal have won last 9 games against Burnley. And they have had longer runs against two important teams, Manchester City until 1994, from 1994 to 2004, and Newcastle United, 10 games that they had won. So I think we have a very fierce rivalry against Newcastle, and we had a good rivalry against a dominating rivalry against Manchester City. And most importantly, at the Emirates, Arsenal have won all 7 games against Burnley, scoring 21 goals and conceding only 4 goals. Arsenal have been the dominating force in an Arsenal versus Burnley clash. That is the history. That is the past. Up until last season. So before the last season, Arsene Wenger era, we destroyed Burnley. 5-0, I think the last Arsenal versus Burnley game under Wenger. 5-0, yeah. But the most important thing is Unai Emery came in last season and Arsenal still won both the games against them. What do we expect this season? Because we have reinforcements, yeah. This team is not the same as last year because we have lost a lot of attacking potential what we had last year, and we've got some new recruits. Some of the recruits cannot be used, but we have certain people who can make a big and vast difference. So here's something that I am planning as a starting 11, what I'm expecting. Yeah, we know the next two games are vastly important for us, very important. Liverpool. Yeah, it's important. But the mother of all derbies, the North London Derby, is next after that. And I'm expecting Obalaka Pepe to start. Aubameyang, Lacazette, and Nicolas Pepe to start. I don't know if Unai Emery is going to start that way, at least for the first half. I want that to happen. In the front line, Obalaka Pepe. And the mid, I'd want Xhaka and Guendouzi to start. Guendouzi makes a lot of sense, but I'd also like to see Torreira. I'd want to see a more attacking midfield. So I'd want either Granit Xhaka or Torreira to start, or I don't mind Granit Xhaka and Matteo Guendouzi. Not an issue for me. And one more person in that midfield marshalling area should be Mesut Ozil. Yes, Mesut Ozil providing the ball to the others. Or I'd like, even if you can start with Ceballos, I'd want to see Ceballos start. Alongside Granit Xhaka, I'd like to see that. Or that is all the case has been three, and we have been named three. The rest, I would prefer a back four line with Sead Kolasinac, David Luiz, Socrates Papastapoulos, and on the right-hand side, Ainsley Maitland-Niles with Baird Leno starting. This is what I believe should be Arsenal's 11. And if you agree with me, mention in the comments what exactly Arsenal should come up with in their playing 11. But even if this is not the case, I'd love to see, if Ozil is not 100% there, I'd like to see Willock Yeah. And instead of Lacazette, I'd like to see Nick Nelson and Aubameyang playing much of a central role. I'd love to see that Nelson, Oba, and Pepe with in the second half. Nelson is out and Lacazette is coming up right at the brink of the second half, and give Lacazette a whole 45 minutes to come and destroy and play his natural game. So he gets a good game time, a good prep before the game against Liverpool. And most importantly, I am expecting Arsenal to again destroy Burnley, at least with a goal margin of 3-0. I'm expecting Arsenal to keep it a clean sheet. Why? The biggest problem with Burnley is that if they get their chances, they're gonna seize it. We have seen that in last season as well. If they get, but the problem is these low-lying teams, their problem is their creativity. Their creativity is marred. Just like how we saw against Newcastle, you bought a 40 million striker. You have a great winger whom you did not start the game, but when he came in, he did good impact with and without the ball as well. So that's Saint-Maximin. So he was really good. I liked it. But the biggest problem is that there was no creativity. Nobody was even bothered to get the ball in the middle to provide the ball. Nobody was. So I am expecting something the same with Burnley as well. They had their issues last season as well, but make no mistake, if our defense creates mistakes like last season, definitely any team can come and score against us. But if we stay solid, I want David Luiz to start this game because I want to see how David Luiz can add an impact, and we'd want to play him instead of Chambers in the next two games. That is North London Derby and most importantly against Liverpool. I want to see that happen. So I'm expecting David Luiz to start. So if the back line is solid, if I'm expecting a solid back line, I don't see Burnley scoring any goals. So I'm also expecting that if Nicolas Pepe is starting, either an assist or a goal is definitely in the name of Nicolas Pepe. So I'm expecting 3-0 or 4-0. Definitely, I think Arsenal will dominate this game because attacking-wise we never had a problem, but defense, we've sorted out the defense in some sort. Yeah, we've made sure that the defense is definitely trustworthy, at least in some way it is trustworthy, and we can definitely sort it out. But make no mistake, Arsenal versus Burnley, always a physical game, and it is a test of Nicolas Pepe whether he can be physical or not. It is a test of Joe Willock if he starts, or Reece Nelson if he starts. Well, if he can take the physicality of the game or not, but obviously, I think everything will be for the first time. And the only reason why I want to see Nicolas Pepe start because I want to see the magic. I've seen the clips in the YouTube. I did not follow Lille a lot last season or a season prior to that, but I want to see him in action for Arsenal, and I'd love to see him start, just like all the fans would. But this is my intention to see Nicolas Pepe start. And to be fair enough, I think the best thing that can happen is Dani Ceballos starting. I think I don't know if many people want to see him start or not, but I'd like to see Dani Ceballos start and show the impact that he has, after coming to Arsenal. I want to see his impact as well. So for the first time in this season, our players are going to play in the home colors, the red and white, and we are really buzzing as fans. I'm really buzzing about this. But make no mistake, I think we can expect a crackerjack of a game as always. But Arsenal versus Burnley, my prediction 3-0 or 4-0, keeping a clean sheet and winning a solid game. No, we're not going to keep a clean sheet just because we were quite, could be some different reasons for that. But no, it'll be a solid clean sheet. That is what I expect them to do. Well, this was the preview of the game Arsenal versus Burnley, which is going to happen tomorrow. And I hope the build-up is there. Yeah, all the fans are excited because again the match day 2 is coming up, and definitely whenever there's a match day, all fans are definitely buzzing in the Premier League, aren't they? Well, these were the news, and I hope you liked it. I hope you loved the pre-match talk. And mention whatever you feel about Arsenal versus Burnley game. What do you feel will be the scoreline? Will we keep a clean sheet or not in the comment section? I love it. And the biggest thing, I think one of my subscribers, Peter Lee, has actually mentioned it. You guys, I'm giving you three options, okay? Three options. And out of these three options, you got to select whom should I roast or what exactly should I roast in my next video, that is today evening, okay? So you guys have the liberty, you guys have the chance to decide who should be roasted, yeah? And the three options are, Number one, Lauren Koscielny. I know I didn't want to put him in there either because I don't think so he's relevant enough now. But come on. I think I can. Next, Chelsea Football Club. The whole of Chelsea Football Club. Well, they've lost two important games in 1 week itself. So I think they're worthy. I always wanted Chelsea to get roasted in a very important big video. If you guys believe it, you can always vote by commenting, you know. Next, Ivan Gazidis. Yeah, Ivan Gazidis, Chelsea Football Club or Lauren Koscielny. Decide. Well, my vote goes to definitely Chelsea Football Club, but I'd like to see what you guys feel about it. So mention in the comment section, Lauren Koscielny, Chelsea Football Club or Ivan Gazidis. Who should be roasted in my today's evening's video? Whatever may be the comments coming in, I know I will be performing a roast on whatever comments, you know, whatever the view your views are. I'd like to see how many people would want to see which of the from these three who should be roasted in my first roast of the week video. Yeah, it's gonna happen today evening. So please mention in the comments and share your opinions. Who should be roasted? Again, I'm going to tell you Lauren Koscielny, Chelsea Football Club or Ivan Gazidis. Who should be destroyed? And I'll make a full-fledged, it should be at least 15 minutes and above. That is what my concern is. It'll be a very big video so that you guys can sit back and relax and enjoy the content that's coming from this channel. So, roast of the week. All the suggestions, please mention in the comments. I'll be reading everyone and deciding who should be roasted in this week's Roast of the Week. I'll see you in my next video. Cheers.